Hello, everyone. You're watching Halborn Flash Videos. I'm Arabdha, and today our guest is Pontem. So, Aleko, welcome to the chat. And would you mind going ahead and introducing yourself?
Thank you for the intro. We're building foundational products for the Aptos ecosystem based on Move. So, I would categorize Pontem as a product studio. The two products that are live now are Pontem Wallet, which essentially is an entry point into Aptos and other Move-based chains in the future. We also have the Liquid Swap AMM. The AMM is essentially right now a constant function market maker, but pretty soon we'll have more functionality such as concentrated liquidity and some cool features that potentially I could go into, but maybe don't want to release that yet. We are also working on essentially building a Move runtime for other chains. So this is how we want to expand the Move ecosystem. So for those that are not familiar with Move, it's essentially a framework on top of Rust for building blockchain applications or smart contracts. So developers really love it because Rust, as many of you know, is a growing language, overtaking very quickly C and other legacy languages as a standard, especially in the lower level computing, which blockchain definitely is. Move, for those of you that don't know, was invented at Facebook and Meta for the Libra, which later became Diem project. Those two now evolved into Aptos and Sui. But Move is meant to be an agnostic language, just like any other language. And we want to provide developers the same optionality that they do with Solidity. So what we're finding is that people really like Ethereum, for example. People really like Bitcoin or Solana or Aptos for their own purposes. You know, they have different guarantees on safety, on performance, and decentralization, et cetera. So we really believe that should be decoupled from the consensus layer, or the layer one, and allow people to build with whatever language they want. And we think Move is more future-proof than Solidity. So, you know, that's our third product. Our big bet on making Move essentially available on other layer one ecosystems. And we recently fundraised a decent amount. We'll be putting out an announcement on that soon. And excited to continue building with this technology and seeing where it takes us.
Great. Congratulations on the fundraise. You definitely answered a lot of my questions on why choose Move and Aptos in the ecosystem. I'm going to take a step back and ask you the story of Pontem itself, because you are one of the founders, and there's definitely an inception story, and we would love to learn a little bit more about that.
Yeah, definitely. Two of my co-founders, Boris and Stas, have been building with the Move language ever since Libra first launched in 2019. That continued through to the evolution of Libra and Diem into what is now Aptos and Sui. At that time, we originally envisioned the same vision that I talked about, essentially having the Move on other ecosystems. As some of you may know, Diem was essentially going to be a permission blockchain where there's going to be a lot of requirements to launch for applications. You know, maybe the decentralization of them was going to be you know, not as much as it could be on a public permissionless environment like Ethereum, Polkadot, Cosmos, etc. So our first our first fundraise over 2 years ago, when the project was developed, was essentially to make this technology, the Move technology, available on permissionless environments. So we created working MVPs for Cosmos, for Polkadot, to start testing out this technology. Some of those frameworks allow for these custom runtimes and custom blockchains to be built. That's how we started as Aptos, and Sui evolved from the Diem project. We shifted our focus to building on the application layer. But our vision still stands to make Move available for everyone. So yeah, we've just been working with the Move tech for a while. I joined Stas and Boris shortly after the first fundraise about 2 years ago, leading product and growth for Pontem.
And your statement just now, making Move available for everyone, is as strong as mission statements go. So why from a business and community perspective, why the choice and preference to go with this?
So we like to say that we're Move maxis. Hopefully that starts to stick. I've heard others start to say it. I would say there's definitely some value in the tribalism that happens in some of these L1s. I think we're seeing, you know, that fragmentation happening. But as a developer, as an application developer, you know, we need to move beyond that tribalism and just think about what's the best user experience for our end users. And I think that's why we're starting to see that tribalism start to fade away for users, for developers, and start to seeing more of these multi-chain deployments. It's evident that, you know, one chain probably isn't going to rule them all, even if, you know, they reach 100,000 TPS, which is kind of like what everyone's touting. If we really have millions, hundreds of millions, billions of people, you know, it's not going to fit all in one place. So we probably need to distribute the bandwidth, at least short term, or think of more ways to scale. And at the end of the day, I just want the best experience for my users, whether that's performance, cost, uptime is really, really important. And we can go into that a little bit. We believe that Move is a better language to build, you know, financial applications. This needs to be as safe as possible. Solidity was definitely a good first try. You're going through doing something for the first time. There's definitely some learnings that can come out of it. And we can go into some details like, you know, the reentrancy errors, which even today are a big issue in Solidity applications. And obviously, as Halborn, I'm sure you see them all the time, right? So like, you know, the ability to use Rust, which is, you know, well adopted and established language, and put some of the guardrails to make it easier to build smart contracts, I think was really, really smart. And, you know, being able to take that invention that came out of this project and take it everywhere, I think is definitely something that should be beneficial for the entire ecosystem. We believe as new entrants into the market, you know, developers that are a little bit more mature or more senior in traditional tech ventures, you know, when they look at and examine, you know, Solidity, which maybe is closer to like a JavaScript, and look at Move, which, you know, has a lot of essentially built on top of Rust, which maybe they may already be familiar with or understand that, you know, it's a better language. We think that, you know, it has the potential to overtake Solidity, and it's still, the ecosystem still so early and nascent. Like if you look at daily active users, you know, we're still in the hundreds of thousands. The costs for Ethereum are still, you know, double digit dollars, and the actual latency and performance of it is still like very, very, I would categorize archaic compared to like a Web2 app. So, you know, as we continue to bring in more developers and this ecosystem continues to expand, we just want to make sure that the foundation is there so that there's parity with Move and Solidity so that, you know, given the choice, what's likely best for their application. And we're already seeing actually some applications that were built natively with Solidity migrate over to Move. PancakeSwap is a good example of that. So yeah, hopefully, you know, we'll start to see more big players and the whole ecosystem garner around Move. And we are starting to see that there's some initiatives on Solana, on Cosmos, on Polkadot, et cetera, us building on Ethereum to bring Move to be widely adopted. So yeah, I think generally people really are excited. When you talk to developers, they're excited about Move. You know, people really like Rust and Solana and Luna for that purpose, just because it was Rust native, giving people the choice or ability to build with Move, which is kind of like a, you know, Rust with guardrails. We think that's a good value proposition and definitely a good mission to undertake.
Fantastic. So it looks like there's more adoption happening in the world of Move and more power to Move in general. Taking a few steps back, can you tell us a little bit about the products that Pontem already has live and where is the product roadmap at? And is there anything that our audience today can go in and already start playing around with?
Yeah, definitely. So right now on Aptos, we have two products that are deployed. One is Pontem Wallet, and that's available as a Chrome extension, as an iOS app, and as a Google Android application. The Chrome extension and the Android application have the most feature-rich, definitely some, you know, barriers to getting stuff on iOS, as people are aware. Definitely go check it out. One of the main features of our applications is that we have native DeFi integrated, so you can use LiquidSwap, which is our AMM, as well, natively integrated there. You can do liquid staking, and soon you'll have more trusted DeFi applications, which have been audited, you know, by trusted auditors such as Halborn. And making sure that, you know, there is some, there's still some walled garden to, you know, what people can access, but getting rid of the browser's intermediary, we expect will be a better user experience and potentially give people a little bit more peace of mind accessing, you know, quote unquote Web3 and not getting drained completely. So, you know, that's our wallet, focusing on safety features, as I mentioned, with native applications, and obviously going cross device. So, that's available now. Definitely one of the most popular wallets on Aptos. The second product that is live that can be used is LiquidSwap, accessible through liquidswap.com. That's essentially a right now basic constant function market maker using the XYK curve. But we are working on more capital efficient models like concentrated liquidity and some iterations there as well on what makes it better than some of the existing solutions. So that's what I'm excited about. You know, first we need to build those, because it's an entirely new ecosystem, first we need to build those foundational products for others to be built on top and for other users to be able to come on and build with those initial Lego blocks. So yeah, a trusted place to access the blockchain, like a wallet, is definitely very needed, and a trusted place to trade assets, A for B, is definitely needed as well. So that's what's live now and available. And yeah, hopefully by next year, we should have, you know, some of our implementations on other L1s as well. But those are more complex products and definitely take more time to build.
So the Pontem wallet and the liquid swap AMM, looking forward to check that out, and also looking forward to the new products coming up the roadmap as well. I alluded a little bit to the security work with Halborn, so I'm going to ask you a little bit more about that. What was the internal security strategy overall for Pontem, and why go with a cybersecurity partner such as Halborn?
Because it's an entirely new ecosystem, we want to make sure that everything we're launching is as safe as possible for doing releases, you know, make sure that things are audited. We're also using redundancy in our audit. So, you know, obviously Halborn is a great partner and we've worked with them, and I won't promote their names, but, you know, working with other auditing firms as well to have redundancy on especially our smart contracts is super, super important, especially because it's an entirely new ecosystem. And Halborn obviously has experience across different chains and ecosystems. So that's definitely valuable for us too, as we're evaluating which auditing firms to use. Yeah, there's definitely a plethora of them out there, but you want to make sure you're working with those that have experience somewhat within what you're building. And given that Move is an entirely new ecosystem, we wanted to look for one that, you know, had diversity and had looked at various ecosystems. So that was a good, you know, that was part of the reason we picked Halborn. But as part of our strategy, you know, we're implementing redundancy in our audit, especially as again, Move is an entirely new ecosystem, and we want to work with others that are also working with other projects in the Move that are building with Move, so that they have also experience, you know, auditing other Move contracts. So, yeah, that's how we're thinking about it. But especially in crypto, you need to think of security first. So anything that touches private keys or funds needs to be fully audited. And even as folks are doing upgrades, you know, even those need to be you know, fully vetted before going live, because any small bug or any small thing can definitely cost a lot of money.
Yeah, definitely. Security first, always. So Alejo, before we end this chat, I have to ask you, based on your vision of Move adoption, what piece of advice would you have for other builders in the same space?
Being grounded on the actual problems that exist today is important. Like, I think it's difficult to stay focused in crypto when things move so fast, and people, at least that I've seen, have kind of short attention spans and are trying to follow trends. But I think trying to cut through that and actually solve the problems that exist today for developers, like, for example, one of the main problems that we're trying to solve is that, you know, Solidity is the only option that you have available to build with on Ethereum, and Ethereum is the most trusted layer one. So and this comes out of talking to, you know, your potential end users. So it's very hard, obviously, to do, and you can do, you know, some sort of survey or try to get, you know, a broad idea of what people want and where the problems are and how you as a company or as an entrepreneur can solve those problems. But I think what's most useful is just getting out to and talking to real users. So, you know, as you're talking to potential integrations or partners, you know, ask them some of the questions that might lead to them using your product or some of the problems that your product might solve. Similarly, when you're going out to events, it's good to get an idea of, you know, where the problems are and how you can solve them. And if you can solve those problems, there's real value. And obviously, some of the trends that happen are grounded on some of those problems. But really, you know, think deeply about how you have a unique value proposition that can solve that problem. So I think for us, that's definitely, you know, making Move available for a lot of people, and then building applications really quickly and more safely and on top of Move, which should also you know, enable a lot of other use cases on top of these applications. So even within that, you know, as we think about you know, our AMM, you know, where are the main problems that exist there? So like how do we think about MEV, how do we think about impermanent loss, and even if it's not at the core protocol, you know, some of the adjacent tooling that can be built in a trusted way to you know, enable these problems to be solved. Just think really deeply about what problems you're solving and how valuable it is to solve those problems.
Right, that was a lot of good suggestions out there. So stay focused on the problem you're solving. Make sure you have a great value proposition. Build fast and test faster. Get your users' feedback is kind of the takeaway for me. Thank you so much for sharing your journey with Pontem so far and also your pieces of advice to the rest of the builder community. It's been great chatting with you and looking forward to all the new updates from Pontem. Thank you.